Greetings to all. Welcome to Learning Management System. I'm Shabana SS, lecturer in Electronics and Communication Department, Government Polytechnic, Ballari. Today we'll start the session 1 of Unit 6, that is Employment. In today's session, we'll see the introduction to employment and also the causes of unemployment. So first, let us try to know what we mean by employment, that is the definition of employment. Employment is a relationship between two parties, that is employer and employee. Employer is the one who provides the job. It may be a corporate organization, a profit or non-profit organization. Employment is typically governed by employment laws and regulations or legal contracts. Employment is actually an agreement between an employer and employee. This agreement tells that the employee will provide certain services on duty. It also tells that the work will occur in employer's designated workplace. Also, the goals and mission of the organization should be accomplished by employee. In return, the employee will receive compensation. Now let's see who an employee is. Employee indre udyogi, kelasagara or kelasa maduvata. So idra definition in nodana. Employee is a person or candidate who is paid for the work or job being carried out by him. He works in return for the payment, which may be in the form of hourly wages, daily wages, monthly salary or annual package. This payment depends on the type of work an employee does and also in which sector he or she is working. That is, it may be a public sector, private sector or government sector. In some sectors, the employees receive additional benefits along with their regular salary payment. These benefits include health insurance, disability insurance, residential quarters, retirement benefits, sick leave, vacations, social security, funding of education, and other specialized benefits. The employees working in public or civil transport services like KSRTC or railway employees, they receive free travel facility for their family. Now, how to find employees or employment? The main way for employers to find workers and for the workers to find employers is via job advertising in newspapers, that is classified advertising, and online. Earlier, searching for employees or employment was a bit difficult process. The only source of information available was newspaper, which was popularly used. But nowadays we have the other popular method, that is internet. Through internet, almost all the information, that is finding the employees or employment, the related information will be available easily. Employers and job seekers also can find each other through professional recruitment consultants. Employer and employee will get to know each other through the process of job interview. Now let us come to the main topic, that is causes of unemployment. So before that, let us just see what unemployment means, that is the definition of unemployment. Unemployment is defined as a situation where a person willing to work fails to find a job. It means that a person is ready to work but he is not able to get a job. In simple terms, unemployment means lack of employment or a state of being unemployed. Unemployment is an important statistic used by the government to gauge the economic condition of a country. Following are some of the important causes or reasons for unemployment. The first one is defective education, then rapid changes in technology, slow economic growth, limited land, seasonal agriculture, backward method of agriculture is also responsible for unemployment, then fragmentation of land, rapidly increasing population, inadequate or insufficient employment planning, poor condition in cottage industries. Now we discuss the causes of unemployment one after the other. The first reason for unemployment is defective education. The day-to-day education system is very defective and it is confined within classrooms only. Its main aim is just to acquire the certificate. The present-day education system is just degree-oriented. It is not job-oriented. This defective education system is responsible for unemployment in many ways because good education is the base for everything. Without good and true education, a person cannot obtain real knowledge. Hence, in all the ways, good education is the most important factor in employment. The next reason is rapid changes in technology. Now, this involves technologies like big data management, Internet of Things, machine learning, robotics, 3D printing, satellite technology, drone technology, and many more. When any new technology is introduced in the market, or if the existing technology is upgraded, it will have both positive as well as negative impacts. The negative impact of change in technology is loss of jobs. If the employee is not updating himself with the changes, there is possibility of losing his job. The introduction of new machinery, labor-saving mechanical machines, or more efficient automation methods minimizes the role of humans in these processes. The next reason for unemployment is slow economic growth. An economy includes all the activities related to production, consumption, and trade of goods and services in an area. Economic growth is increase in production of economic goods and services from one period of time to another. It is measured in terms of GDP, that is gross domestic product. Economic growth comes from land, labor, capital, and entrepreneurship. Now, our Indian economic growth is a bit slow. This is due to poor industrialization, low agriculture production, less investment in international market, and less investment in tourism. This slow economic growth will fail to offer enough job opportunities to our growing population. The next reason is limited land. Land is a gift of nature. It is always constant and cannot expand like population. Since India's population is increasing at a very fast rate, the available land is not sufficient for this growing population. As a result, there is heavy pressure on land. In rural areas, most of the people depend on land for their livelihood. Hence, it creates unemployment on a large scale for the people who depend on agriculture in rural areas. Now, let's see the another important reason which creates unemployment in our country. That is seasonal agriculture. In rural society, agriculture is the main means of employment. Most of the rural people, they are engaged in agricultural work directly or indirectly. But in India, agriculture is basically a seasonal affair. That means it provides employment only in a particular season of the year. That is, only in sowing period and harvesting period, people are fully employed. And in the period between post harvesting and next sowing, they remain unemployed. This adversely affects their standard of living. Also in India, agriculture mainly depends on rainfall. Hence, it creates unemployment in summer season. The next reason is backward method of agriculture. The agriculture methods used in India are very backward. The rural farmers follow the same old farming methods. They do not have sufficient irrigation facilities, finance, marketing facilities, etc. Also, they are not at all aware of the scientific methods of cultivation. Due to this, there is low agriculture production and the farmers are not able to provide proper education to their children or engage them in any profession, which leads to unemployment problem. The next reason for unemployment is fragmentation of land. Fragmentation means breakdown of land holdings into smaller fragments of land. That means dividing the land into smaller portions. Now, why this division is done? The main reason for this is inheritance, population growth, etc. This fragmentation of land leads to higher cost of production, lower crop yields, and lower profitability. As land is fragmented and agriculture work is being hindered, the people who depend on agriculture remain unemployed. It also creates poverty among the rural people. The next reason is rapid increase in population. Highly populated countries like China, India are a global threat to unemployment. India has a population of 139 crores in the year 2020. This is equivalent to 17.7% of the total world population. Nearly 50% of our population are youngsters seeking jobs in India. The rate of unemployment constantly increases with periodical increase in population. The next reason is inadequate employment planning. The employment planning of government is not adequate in comparison to the population growth. That means the planning is not suited or suitable to the growing population. The employment opportunities are not increasing in accordance to the proportionate rate of population growth. On the other hand, it is a very difficult task on the part of government also to provide sufficient job facilities to the growing population. The next reason which creates unemployment is poor condition in cottage industries. Cottage industries are home-based units of production. Here, people produce goods such as wool in their home itself. In villages, unemployment is due to lack of cottage industries. Products like textiles, carpets, cane furniture, etc. are produced in the cottage industries. Small-scale cottage industries are the main source of employment in rural areas. Currently, the cottage industries are in a winding stage. Since the industrial development has replaced the cottage industry, most of the rural population remains unemployed. The last one is lack of transport and communication, which will lead to unemployment, especially in rural areas. In rural areas of India, there are no adequate facilities for transport and communication. Hence, the people who stay in villages, they are not engaged in agricultural work, so they remain unemployed. This is because they are not able to start any business for their livelihood as they are confined to the limited boundary of the village. So there are many reasons for unemployment. We have just discussed a few of them. Now let's see some of the multiple choice questions along with options and answers related to employment. The first one is, employment is an agreement between A. employer and organization, B. employer and employee, C. employee and contractor, D. none of the above. So the right answer, as we know, is B, that is employer and employee. This was discussed in the beginning of the session, that employment is an agreement between two parties, that is employer and employee. So the right answer is B. The second one, unemployment is defined as, the options are, a situation where a person is willing to work but fails to find a job. B. lack of employment. C. state of being unemployed. Or D. all of the above. Now the right answer is D. all the above. That means unemployment definition is a situation where a person willing to work fails to find a job. Also, we can define unemployment as lack of employment. It is also defined as state of being unemployed. Hence, all the above answers are right. The next question is, what type of unemployment is found in the agriculture sector of India? The options are A. industrial unemployment, B. seasonal unemployment, C. disguised unemployment, or D. educational unemployment. So what's the answer? The answer is B and C. That is, in agriculture sector, we see seasonal unemployment and disguised unemployment. As we have seen the definition or the meaning of seasonal unemployment already in the previous slides, so let me just tell it once again. Seasonal unemployment is, it provides employment only in a particular season of the year, that is in the sowing and harvesting period. In the remaining period, the people remain unemployed, that is seasonal unemployment. Now, disguised unemployment, this is when more than required people work in a field, the extra persons are in disguised unemployment. A person seems to be working, but he is actually unemployed. The next question. What type of unemployment is found in developed countries? The options are A. involuntary unemployment, B. voluntary unemployment, C. structural unemployment, D. disguised unemployment. The right answer is B, that is voluntary unemployment. So what we mean by voluntary unemployment? Voluntary means willingly. So here in this type of unemployment, work to the people is easily available, but they are not ready to work on the prevailing or existing wage rate. So they are voluntary unemployed. The next question is, if a person is ready to work at the existing wage rate in the market, but he is not able to find the work, then what type of unemployment would it be called? The options are A. voluntary unemployment, seasonal unemployment, C. involuntary unemployment, or D. structural unemployment. The correct answer is C. Here, a person is willing to work but is not able to find a job. He is willing to work at the existing wage rate but is unable to find a job. So this comes under involuntary unemployment. In this type of unemployment, the person wants to work or he is ready to work but he does not get the job because the economy is lacking in providing the job. The next question, what type of unemployment is found in India? The options are A, industrial unemployment, B, educational unemployment, C, technological unemployment, or D, all of the above. So what is the right answer? In our country, we have all types of unemployment, that is related to industry, industrial unemployment, educational unemployment, technological unemployment. So the right answer is D, all of the above. The next question, the various effects of unemployment are, the options are A, financial problems, B, social problems, C, psychological problems, or D, all of the above. Here the question is related to what are the effects, various effects of unemployment. That is, if a person is unemployed, what are the effects? So the effects are various. That is, he faces financial problems if he is unemployed. There will be social problems as well as psychological problems. So the right answer is D, all of the above. The next question is, unemployment can be reduced by? Option A is more investment in agriculture. B, increase the supply of skilled labor. C, promoting small business. Or D, all of the above. That is, how we can reduce unemployment. So unemployment can be reduced by all the above. Answer is D. That is, we can reduce unemployment by investing more in agricultural field, then by increasing the supply of skilled labor and promoting or encouraging small scale business. Next one, poverty and dash are twin problems found in India. So how shall we fill the blank? The options given are crime, then child labor, then unemployment, and casteism. So what is a suitable match for the blank? So in India, poverty and unemployment both are twin problems which Indians are facing. So the right answer is C, that is unemployment. The last bit, which is not a remedial measure for unemployment. The options are A, population control, B, educational reforms, C, 5-year plans, D, political reforms. So what is the right answer? The right answer is D. So how we can conclude that it is D? So what is asked in the question is, what is not a proper measure for unemployment? Which is among the following, which is not the correct method to reduce unemployment? So population control, by doing population control, we can reduce unemployment problem. Also, by changes in the present education system, education policy, by changes in the education policy also we can reduce unemployment. And 5-year plans also can reduce the unemployment. So the political reforms does not come under reducing unemployment. So the right answer, that is political reforms, it is not a remedial measure for unemployment. So this is all for today's session. We'll meet again in the next session. Thank you one and all.